Hi, it's Dr. Centeno, and today we're going to focus on new research that shows that your knee x-ray is probably pretty useless in diagnosing why your knee hurts, or at least it's not as valuable as we once thought. Now, this may come as a complete surprise to you because x-rays and MRIs are commonly used by physicians to make the diagnosis of arthritis and then conclude that that's why the knee hurts. So if we look at the standard x-ray grading scale, we can see that it goes from normal to mild to moderate to severe arthritis on an x-ray. And it would be very, very attractive to say that this grading scale equals pain, meaning the more arthritis you have on the x-ray, the more your knee has to hurt. Regrettably, a lot of research, not just the little bit of research I'll go over here today, but a lot of research has shown that that's not the case at all. So this will look at a new study of the pain marker called MPY, and the name of the marker isn't really that important. MPY is neuropeptide Y, but it's just that there is a marker that you can get out of the knee that correlates well with knee pain, and that's the citation of the recent research on this pain marker. And what's really interesting is that if you look at the levels of this pain marker in the knee, there's a very elegant association between the levels of this pain marker and pain that people report. So that's the level if you're healthy. This is the level if you have some osteoarthritis but no pain. This is the level if you have mild pain and knee arthritis. This is the level if you have moderate pain, and then strong pain, and then severe pain. So you can see this very elegant relationship between the amount of pain that people are reporting and the levels of this pain marker in their knee. On the contrary, though, if we look at the amount of arthritis that's on an x-ray, like we just did, and then track that versus this pain marker, which is directly associated to how much pain people are reporting, here's what we see. So that's the amount of pain marker if there's nothing on the x-ray. And then that's the amount of pain marker if there's early arthritis, and then moderate arthritis. But we kind of lose the association in severe arthritis on the x-ray. In fact, all of this should look like that. We should see much, much more pain marker in folks with severe arthritis on their x-ray, but we're not seeing that. Now, while this may come as a big surprise to you that the x-ray isn't all that valuable in correlating with pain, again, there are numerous other studies that show that x-rays and MRIs are not that great at predicting who has knee pain and who doesn't. So in conclusion, we have to stop perpetuating the urban myth as physicians that an x-ray or MRI can readily explain why someone has knee pain. This is a 1980s concept. This is not a concept that holds water in 2014 or 2015. So again, recognize that this fancy picture that you got with the fancy radiology report, whether it was an x-ray or an MRI, doesn't necessarily readily explain why your knee hurts. And I know that's hard to wrap your head around because there's still a lot of physicians perpetuating this urban myth, but it is an urban myth nonetheless. Thanks for watching.